morning, 10 a.m. local. 1800 Zulu. Just doing an FS economy flight here. I've just played with my view settings the other session. And now I've played with my zoom setting, I suppose, a bit, and the lateral placement of your eye point, things like that, so that signs are more readable from within the cockpit. It's a more normal eye zoom sort of distance. I don't have to zoom in or wait till I'm right next to the sign to see it. I can read it just like I really could in real life. But also, on the left-hand side here, which I haven't finished yet, I'm working on sliding the screen over a bit so that I can get my little corner view for when I'm flaring to land. As you can probably imagine, your nose is pitched up. You can't see forward through that nose. Your only view of the runway is off to the sides. And that's a very important or very helpful thing to look at when you're coming in to land, during your flare, I should say. Might be a little slow on my speech. Still working on my first coffee today. About 900 RPM gives us about enough power to continuously taxi here. I feel like I still need to drop my eye point down more. But we'll try that on the next flight. I'll just do it little by little. Looking outside to see the windsock is relatively calm. I'm going to be a northbound today, so hence why we're taxiing parallel to the runway southbound. So we can turn around and depart off, I think it's going to be 3-4. Yeah, 3-4. I haven't really gotten into messing with the GPS map too much. I don't refer to it very often unless I'm lost or something, maybe. Just trying to get back into simming, starting at the basics, VFR, pilotage, dead reckoning, chart reading, all that kind of basic stuff, you know. Running X-Plane 12 as usual. I just like it a lot better than Microsoft. Microsoft looks really good, don't get me wrong, but it's pretty nice. And I like the feel of it much better. Just feels more right to me. All right, let's hold short here. Just gonna hold my brakes because flying FS Economy, if I activate my parking brake, there's a setting right now where it'll automatically end my flight, which I don't want. So I'm just gonna hold my brakes while I do my run up. 1700 RPM. Mag check. Extra check. Extra functions. Run up complete. Running lights on, strobe lights on. Lights. Camera. Action. Fuels on both. Trim set for takeoff. Neutral. Parking brakes released. Brakes are off. Let's go. We're going to shoot for 3,000 feet cruise altitude today. It's not a long flight, and 3,000 and below, we don't have to adhere to the evens and odds kind of rule there, so we'll just stay 3,000 or less. It's really smooth, I like it. You know, I'm only getting 30 frames, but that's pretty smooth. I'm okay with that. I need more RAM though, I need another 32 gigs. I should have done 64 when I had this PC built, but I wasn't thinking. I was being cheap. Displaced threshold right here. The arrows indicate we're good for taxiing and takeoff, I believe it is, but not landing there. But I'll have to verify in the aim. I'm going to taxi up to the runway markers, or the runway numbers, and we'll depart from there. 6,000 feet of runway left. Yeah, 6,600 total, 150 feet wide. We just passed the 6,000 foot indication, number 6 on both sides of the runway. Coming up to the threshold now. All right, flaps are up. Everything's ready to go. We're ready for takeoff. Airspeed alive. 55 knots will rotate. Speed, light rotate, nose is up, wheels off the ground for the main wheel, for the nose wheel, sorry. There we go, we have liftoff. Little right rudder to keep her set there. Now see, this is what I mean, I can't see the actual runway. You can see out that corner, but I'll have to adjust that more because I don't want to lean like that, because in a real plane you don't need to. 79 to 80 knots for departure, VY. I should say for takeoff anyway. So the base club. Hey, we got our Vancouver VR tuned in. That's good. See, the bases are so low, I'm already at them. I got a pitch over here. Head out underneath those. Yeah, we want to stay way under those. Already getting a little bit too far in. Hopefully I can still see the river and stuff like that, so we'll see what happens. You can see the waterways over there, heading out towards the ocean, so we'll just stay clear of these clouds as best we can. It's clearing up now. Trying to keep her level for now on the climb, but it was a really short climb out. We're only at 1,000 feet now, but VFR, right? Not much traffic on the ground for a Sunday morning. We hit the NDB, I'll put a timer on. Probably not going to make our turn yet. We're going to stay going the direction we're in. Very cool. I love this. These clouds, this weather. It's pretty sweet. I like the patchiness of it. Looks very realistic. Just wish the reflections in the water looked better. That looks really bad. But X-Plane 12 and a half, maybe they'll fix that. Who knows? I'm happy though. It's pretty good. Landing lights off. trying to keep it VFR. Hopefully as the morning progresses and the temperature rises a bit, for it lost 2 degrees up 1,000 feet, that's about standard temperature lapse. And anyway, hopefully it'll break these clouds up a bit, or lift them up anyway. Need a little bit of wind too, I guess, but hey, we're just about over the ocean now, or the strait. So we'll proceed on course here. Actually, we'll continue a little further. I'm gonna go around this puffy cloud here, and then hopefully get around the back of this one. We'll see. I'm only at 2200 RPM, about 100 knots airspeed. There's my hole right there, then we'll get back on course. I'm still south of my localizer. As we're showing here, the localizer is off to the left of my track, but it's also pointing to the north side of the compass. So I'm headed mostly north here, predominantly north, so I will be getting close to this as we get, as time passes here, so it'll start swinging in eventually. Let's resume our climb. just about through the cumulus now. You can see the North Shore Mountains already almost. I've got my localizer there. It's now to the south of my course. But I don't want to go through the clouds because I am flying VFR. So I'll just wait till I get around them here. And then we'll head over that way. We're at 2,800 feet maximum to climb. And then we can't climb anymore. We'll have to level out because we plan to do 3,000 feet. So we'll stick to that. That'll get us up high enough for the glide slope intercept as well. 600 feet to go. I'm not on VATSIM right now, so I'm not tuning my comm radios or anything. Feet to go. Still got sight of the North Shore Mountains there. Let's start leveling out. Beauty. What a great day. Still getting 40 frames, so that's nice. And the localizer is well south of us. Gonna begin turning south now. Cloud a little bit here on the tail end. Waiting for my localizer needle to start swinging from right to left now. I can see the glide slope seems to be just slightly coming down. Rather, we're approaching it, it's not moving, but you know what I mean. As soon as I get past these clouds, I'd like to get a little more to the right of my current heading and track. 10 minutes out so far from Nanaimo. Maybe about 13 in actuality, though. I didn't start my timer till outbound from the NDB. Made it around that cumulus stuff. Looking at 40 frames average right now. I'm locked in for 30, so I'm not sure how it's at 40, but that's okay. Okay, localizing needles there. I wasn't paying attention. Let's start turning inbound. We're just below 3,000 feet. On, strobe lights on, fuel set to both, mixture full rich, pre-landing checklist complete. Right on the localizer, let's turn now to stay on it. Glide slope's coming down nice, a little bit there, we're intercepting that. I've got the field in sight, but I still want to keep it on the localizer just for practice. And I won't start adding flaps until we're pretty close to that little spit, or whatever you want to call it, that piece of land coming out from the mainland there. Okay, we're pretty close to right on here. There we go. Keeping our speed up, not slowing down at all. reducing a little bit of power to control my descent. Glide slope's a little bit below me now. I don't have flaps extended, so I'm gonna perform a side slip here to lose a little bit of altitude. Up to the spit here. Once we are beam that, I'll throw my first stage of flaps. Happy looks good from out here. Oh, beautiful. Nice. Approach. Excuse me. Okay, we're on final, runway 8 right, visual. Second stage flaps. Everything's staying right where it is on the windscreen. So that's a good visual cue that you're on a perfect, nice descent. You want the perspective to stay the same. So for example, I have two fingers between my dash panel and where I'm looking at the bottom of the runway, like the approach end of the runway. And if you can keep those two fingers gap and it stays right where it is, you're on a great descent. I don't trim out my final stage of flaps, just in case in the event of a go around, I don't want a whole bunch of nose up trim pressure, so I'll just muscle it in. Up as long as I can. Hear that stall horn screaming. There we go. Lights off, landing lights off, taxi lights on. Set the parking brake for FSE. I'm gonna shut her down here. Just a nice quick flight.